LINQ has been around for 16 years already. That's like it's been here forever. And still, there exist C# programmers who have trouble seeing its ultimate purpose, seeing the place LINQ takes in their designs. That place exists. LINQ is more than just a fancy syntax that takes the loops and ifs away. It is an integral part of your object-oriented and functional design, side by side with the type system, a web framework, or a database schema. It is easy to grasp when you remove syntax from view. Syntax can obscure the substance, so let me show it to you. It begins with the data, lots of data. There is an object, many objects created by deserializing the raw data. And there is a collection of objects to bind them, which is also an object. We always had an issue iterating from many objects, so the iterator pattern came to unify all the distinct ways we applied to walk from many objects. You can learn more about the iterator pattern from another video on my channel. Subscribe to my channel and watch other videos there. The iterator supports arrays, lists, linked lists, dictionaries, hash tables, trees, and all other collections of objects in a unified way. That even gave rise to dynamically evaluated sequences of objects, those that don't even require an in-memory collection to execute. Well, that was efficient. In .NET, you can represent any sequence or a collection with an object implementing the IEnumerable interface. On the other end, you would either consume the iterator via forEach or, if there are special needs, by using the IEnumerable directly. That is one half of the equation, the data. The other half is the operation applied to each object. In a long and tedious process of trial and error, the programming principles have converged to another pattern, the strategy. Rather than effectively doing stuff to objects, we often represent the operation as a dependency. That turns the consumer of the iterator pattern into scaffolding. Enter LINQ, the ultimate consumer of any iterator. We feed all kinds of strategies to the LINQ operators. A mapping goes into select and aggregate, a predicate goes into where, a mapping to a sorting key goes into order by, a combination of those goes into group by. This picture shows you the position of LINQ, but it does not show how that maps to an application you may be developing. Let's add more elements. On the left, there will be a data source. It could be a network interface or persistence, such as database. In any case, it would be a source of the data our application requires. Each interface would transform the backing raw data into a sequence of objects, an object implementing the iterator design pattern. Each interface is a concrete adapter, another design pattern that works under the hood. It transforms whatever the structure may be in the underlying data source into an iterator. That shows the ubiquity of iterators in modern programming. I have indicated a web request, an ORM entity framework, and a micro ORM such as Dapper as three vastly different adapters, each serving an iterator on its output. The strategies on the other extreme may come from all sorts of places. They may also be a part of a larger pattern, a specification, which you can implement to separate some expressions from the iterator. This picture shows a hidden gem of modern .NET programming. Where have all the patterns gone? They went under. Watch this video to learn why there are so few patterns in .NET application development today. The answer may surprise you. .NET is swarming with pattern implementations. They are implemented there, so you don't have to implement them in your custom code. Watch that video for examples of how .NET saves you from writing tons of repeating code. And if you want to learn more, you can join the growing community on my Patreon page, where you will find the source code for all the videos on my YouTube channel. There's a Discord server associated with this channel, where you can participate in discussions and ask questions about C# and .NET programming. You can find all the links in the description. Back to the picture, you can already see that the expressions have no connection with the definition of raw data or the way data are stored and fetched. In between resides a link to join these two in a part of the application that is responsible for that precisely. That would be a controller or handler that executes the request on a high level. It might defer processing to an application service. That depends on your selected design, but you see my point already. The actual role of LINQ is to separate the logic expressed in domain-related strategies from the external data. It uses the iterator implementations provided by infrastructural components. I hope that you have learned something about how you can use a LINQ in your designs effectively. Subscribe to my channel and learn more about the practical uses of C# and .NET from other videos I have made.